With this workflow, you can automatically scan Reddit and specifically the n8n subreddit to be able to find what people are posting. That way you can find the workflows and tools that people are talking about and have a link directly to them so you can go and download them without ever actually having to go to Reddit yourself. All right, let's go ahead and take a look. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna hit execute workflow. And what it's gonna do is it's gonna go to Reddit. It's going to pull the past 90 hot, I believe they're hot posts. We'll take a look in a second. And it's gonna compare them to what I already have scraped in the past. It's then gonna run through each one and determine whether or not those posts meet my criteria of being either a workflow, a video that talks about a workflow, or a tool that I might be able to use in my n8n workflows to be able to make them more effective. It's then gonna run through all of those. Once it figures out which ones don't count, it's gonna kick them back. It's gonna find the ones that do seem worth it. It's gonna then figure out whether or not we're looking at a tool. If it is looking at a tool, so like maybe some API service out there that can do graphics or something, who knows? It's then gonna go to their website. It's gonna pull off their website a summary of what it does. It's gonna take all of that information from the post and the links and everything, and it's gonna put it all neatly into a Google Sheet for my review. And so we see here, it's currently running through, it's run through 31 items. We have another, you know, we've got 89 total that we're doing. And so it's got a little ways to go, but let's go ahead and take a look at the spreadsheet while it's finishing up. So I had 29 in here. And so we've got a whole bunch more. We see here, we've got somebody's post, 99% of n8n AI chatbots for spreadsheets suck. And here's a video link. This post shares an n8n workflow featured on a YouTube video that improves AI chatbots for spreadsheets by using PostgreSQL for efficient and scalable context management instead of loading entire sheets. How cool is that? Instead of having to go and hope that I find something on Reddit, I now have this set every day to check on my behalf. So it just goes and it looks at Reddit for me every single day. It pulls this information. Here we got somebody else's product. This post introduces Vibe n8n, an AI assistant tool designed to enhance productivity. All right, we've got centrado.io. This post introduces a new SaaS tool called Centrado designed to make building n8n workflows easier through guided AI agents. Okay, here we have, this next one is an n8n workflow itself. This introduces an n8n workflow called Content Farming V3 that automates blog content creation by publishing hourly high SEO articles. So let's go take a look at this. Let's just go to it. All right. And here we go. And so this looks like somebody's offering this one for sale. So maybe not necessarily one that I want to grab. That's a big old workflow. But okay, but it gave it to me. Here we got one on GitHub. Introduces a Discord trigger bot that sends messages to an n8n workflow. All right. And so hopefully you see the power of this. I can now set pretty much whatever subreddit that I want, and I'm using n8n as an example here, because I'm able to go get my n8n workflows from it, but you might have another one that you prefer. And it's just gonna process them all, just gonna run through them all, anything in the past day, you know, it's gonna pull, I have it set to pull 90. And I'm currently, I have a free app with Reddit. If you are interested in learning how to develop your own Reddit app, I will put a link in the description below on how to set that up. But what I have here, I'll just come in here and it's, you know, I have my credentials set up. I'm using a get many operation in the subreddit of n8n and I have it set to 90. The free API allows you to do, I'm not particularly clear on this. You're allowed to do 100 actions per minute. And I don't know if that means I'm only allowed to pull 100 things per minute or I can do this 100 times a minute. Either way, I only had it set to 90. I have it set to the hot posts rather than say like the top posts or the new posts. I have hot in here because if it was the top post, I'm gonna be pulling stuff from days and days ago. If it's new post, it's mostly just people complaining about stuff. Hot was a nice happy medium that included a whole bunch of the information that I'm looking for. And what it does is, I guess I'll go ahead and explain. Looks like we're done. So we finished up, got everything in here. It looks like I got 10 total. Out of all of the different posts that I was able to find, it was able to get me 10 additional things. Here's another video. Here's a video. Here's another tool down here. Another video, another video. All right, so it looks like it was kind of a slow day on Reddit. Not too many fantastic workflow posts today. But I have it set for a schedule trigger. All I gotta do, you know, I have it set to run at midnight every day. It's gonna pull the 90 past hot posts that it's able to find. If there are more during the day, you can always set this to check every 6 hours, I guess, or every 8 hours, 12 hours, check every hour if you'd like. And it's just gonna pull them out. It's gonna compare them to what I already have in my spreadsheet. All right, so we came over here. And so, like I said, I started, at like 24, I think it was, 29, somewhere up here. I don't remember. Either way, it added 10. And it's gonna check to see what I already have in my list. It's going to then sort out the ones that are have already been seen here in Reddit. So the ones that are in Reddit, if I already have in my spreadsheet, it just knocks that out. It's not gonna check that one. In fact, it looks like there was one. So of these 90, one of them got caught. So we only got 89 items passing through. We sent each one through in the loop individually. So a batch size of one. I have this edit field node here just to lock down the information so that way it gets logged properly at the end. That way I don't have to call outside of the loop. I put a set field node here. So we grab the title of our Reddit post, the self text, so that's the text that somebody wrote for the Reddit post, as well as the URL of the Reddit post itself. All right. And so that way we can find it again if necessary. We have an AI agent here that's getting the title of the post as well as the post copy. And its job, and I think I'm using a 4.1 nano, so really small model, super fast model. Its job is just to determine whether or not this fits one of my criteria here. Is this an n8n workflow that they're giving away? Does this demonstrate or showcase an n8n workflow in a video? Or is this highlighting a tool or service that might be useful for n8n workflows? If it's one of those things, and it needs to contain at least one working non-image link to the source, all right? So I found that when I was running this before, people would just sometimes put pictures of their workflow and go, aha, I put my workflow, not good enough for me. I want the actual link to either the workflow or the video that I can watch to be able to copy, maybe even to their community, so that I can get a copy of that workflow, all right? It determines whether or not they are worth looking at or not. If not, it just kicks it back to the beginning of the loop and goes to the next one. If so, it then goes forward and then it pulls out some information. So again, we're giving it the title of the post as well as the post copy. And here we're getting a summary of the post written. We're figuring out what kind of post it was. Is it giving away a workflow? Is it a video or is it a tool? As well as grabbing a link to the video. All right, we also have an extra field here called tool summary that's empty. And it's empty so that this merge node works later, so don't worry too much about that. But if it's a workflow or a video, it then sends everything forward and maps it to summary, to main link, and to tool summary, which again is just gonna be empty. And then if it is a tool, so somebody's service, somebody's API tool that they have available, some new thing that came out that'll do whatever, we run it through this HTTP node here. I'm using a service called Gina or Gina.ai, and it's the URL is https://r.gina.ai/, and then the URL. And what this is, and it's set to Git, and this is an AI website review service that will look at the website, strip out any extra HTML that's not necessary, strip out all the stuff that's not readable or would bloat out an AI model, and it just returns the text on the page. So then we get that, and we run it through another AI agent that takes that information, and its job is to just take whatever was off of the website and give me a summary of that website. So what is the tool? What can the tool do? How can it help users? We have some thought process it needs to follow here. It's just a chain of thought. We give it its output format, some things not to do, and then some examples of how to operate. And then it's supposed to paraphrase. It's not supposed to just list out everything on the website. And then that's it. So then it then runs through an edit fields node. It's gonna set tool summary to the value. And then we have this all merged together using a append that gets combined with an aggregate. And then that way, so now we will have a summary, we'll have our main link, and we'll have a tool summary even if it's empty. So we get all of that information. And then that gets put into this Google Sheets node. The Google Sheets is just a resource sheet within document, operations append. The document is what this one here, and I'll give you a copy of this. It's the Reddit n8n workflow finder. All right, and just sheet one, and we mapped it to our our different columns here. So we have post title, post link, post copy, the link, the summary, and the tool review, which would be that tool summary. Now, if it doesn't have a tool summary because it was a workflow or a video, this will just be undefined. And so it's just gonna be empty. So you don't have to worry about it. It's still gonna pass information every single time. It's not gonna break. If we didn't have a tool summary here for our workflows and videos, I told you I had to include it. If we didn't have this here, this would be null. And that would actually break this. And so I had to make sure it had something to be able to process. And so it just is undefined. It doesn't add anything, but it'll add it all to your spreadsheet for you. And like I said, you just set this every single day and then let it run. And you're just going to get a list every day of new workflows that are coming out that you're going to be able to download and use for yourself. And if you'd like a copy of today's workflow, just click the link in the description below to go to my free school community where you can grab this, as well as a host of other workflows for n8n, tons of tutorials, tons of videos explaining how to set up agentic systems. And if you want additional help, if you'd like some, you know, hand-holding, if you'd like some advanced version of my workflows, as well as a copy of my Roger 3.0 AI executive assistant that's capable of handling email and calendar, as well as taking notes and acting on those notes, and reiteratively acting on those notes, not just one-off, really cool tool. You want to look at my advanced community. I'll have a link in the description below for that as well. And if you like this video, please make sure to subscribe to the channel, like and share the video. It really does help get this information out there to those who need it. And as always, I'm Bradford Carlton. Let's automate your success together.